This is the Pro871C cable locator. This is the new version. You can tell this from the original version that the case is gray with yellow trim versus the old one having a black case. The battery installation on this is the same as the original. We have 8D batteries in the transmitter located here. You just take these two thumb screws off, place your batteries in, replace the cover, and you're ready to go. On the receiver, your battery compartment is located here. You have 1 9-volt. Pretty easy replacement. When you install the batteries, to test whether you've done it correctly, just simply turn on the receiver. If you get LED lights on, you've obviously got battery power. Same thing on the transmitter. This is your on-off switch. When I turn it on, I get a power light, and I get a light here. As long as you've got lights, you've got power. The Pro871C has 5 different ways of tracking cables, and all of these functions are controlled here on the control panel. So first thing, I have my on-off switch here. It's a rocker switch. Just put it in the on position, and now you're transmitting in whatever way you set it up. This little knocker knob here will automatically shut the transmitter off when you shut the case tightly. It comes down, hits the rocker, turns it off, saves your batteries. Okay, to change the method of transmission on this 871, this button here where it says frequency is going to do that. So when it comes on, the default is the high frequency. That's a 33 kilohertz signal. It's used for direct connection locating. It's kind of a multi-purpose, general purpose frequency. If I hit the button next, the LED changes to low. That takes it to a 2 kilohertz signal. Same thing, general cable locating. You can choose which of these two works best for you. The third position when I hit frequency is induction. Okay, induction is used for either the inductive antenna that's built in here into the case under what looks like a little bit of a hockey puck and 3 screws. There's an antenna built in there. Or you use it with the inductive clamp, which we'll talk about a little more later. The inductive clamp is going to plug into this port here, but that's how you send a signal for the clamp, is to put it in the induction mode. The fourth LED on here is the transmit light, and that is, for lack of a better phrase, just telling you how much power am I putting out on the cable to be able to track it. The brighter that light blinks, the better your locate is going to be, the more current is flowing down that cable. If it's a weak light, you're not going to get a good locate. These two ports here, the red and black, are for these alligator clip connections. And when I talk about direct connection, this is what I'm talking about. You're taking one of the alligator clips. Well, first I'll plug them in for you. These are standard multimeter connections. So if these leads ever go bad, if you need them replaced, etc., you can go anywhere and get these. You don't need to come for us. Okay, this usually is connected to the wire that I want to track. And with the ground stake that's included up here, the black usually goes on that, and then it goes in the ground in the dirt. Okay, I'll set that back. The receiver, called receiver, sometimes called the wand. It's a bright day out today. This is your on-off switch, and also it doubles as a volume control. When I turn that on, there's a power light here. Really hard kind of see in this light, but it says it's on here with this LED. It defaults to null. Null means that when you're traveling over the cable, you get no signal. If I switch it to peak, it's just the opposite. Now the majority of the signal is over the cable. Null is kind of nice, because when you're right over the cable, you know specifically where that cable is. If you go 3 inches to the left or 3 inches to the right, you'll get signal, but right over that cable, you get nothing. That's called null. And peak is just the opposite. This is an important control here, where we also have frequency. When I put the transmitter on low, for this wand to work, it also has to be on low. So right now it says high. So I need the transmitter and the receiver to both be on the same frequency or the same function. This is on high, that's on high, it works. This switches it to low. Now we go to induction. Now you see then that one, when they're both on the same frequency, I got a signal, but when they weren't, I got nothing. So you have to be on the same setting for both the transmitter and the receiver. In that case, it was induction. But these are your 4 settings. Now one here, the last one, says 60 hertz. That one has nothing to do with the transmitter. Okay, what you're basically doing is turning off the electronic filters in the wand and making it a broadband receiver and picking up the 60 hertz AC noise that you get from electrical service. So the electrical service that comes out of this building, if I wanted to track it without using the transmitter, I could put this receiver in 60 hertz and I would track that buzzing signal that electricity naturally makes across the yard, field, whatever it is you're tracking for. Very nice feature for avoiding active electrical wires. This is your headset jack. The headset comes with the unit. Analog meter is going to give you a visual indication of your signal strength. And this is your speaker, your external speaker, so that if you don't want to use the headset, you don't have to. Both of these are going to give you an audible indication of your signal strength. So that's the A71, the features that it has, and now we're going to talk a little bit about how they work in practice. Now we're going to show you how to use the 871 using the direct connection method or the alligator clips. The way we do that, of course, is this is our power button. We're going to turn that on. But first I want to put in the alligator clips in the appropriate ports. So black into black, red into red. Take the red lead, connect it to the wire that you want to track. Make sure I'm going to use this one here. The black lead goes to your ground stake. This is the ground stake here. Take it out of your case, connect the black lead, shove it in the dirt. The deeper you can put that in, the better your connection you can make, the better your locate is going to be, because the signal travels through the wire, down that wire, and returns through the ground stake. So the better connection, the more signaling you get to flow. So we're going to turn it on now. This light here, the transmit light, is very important in your locating, because it basically is an indication of how much current are we getting to flow. The more current that flows, the better your signal, because you're tracking that current. So that is shown here by the blinking light. The brighter that blinking light, the more current you're getting to flow, and of course the better the tracking is going to be. So that's a critical one to keep an eye on. Additionally, you have two direct connection frequencies, high, which is the default frequency, and low. They are changed here by this frequency button, high, low. It also goes to induction, but we talk about that in a different segment. High, low, okay. So right now it defaults on high, and this is my wand or my receiver. When I turn this on, it's gonna confirm that we have a signal. And when I turn it on, that light, that reception mode has to be in high if the transmitter's in high. If the transmitter is in low, the wand has to be in low. We change that by pushing this frequency button between the different frequency modes. The inductive clamp with the 871C is a really useful tool to use if you want to track wire, especially if you don't want to disconnect that wire, cut somebody's service off, you know, whatever it is. A lot of cable companies, they don't want to cut grandma's internet service off, so they'll use an inductive clamp as opposed to disconnecting and using direct connection method. So the way that you're going to do that is, this is the IC2 clamp, okay, and I've got it set up around this conduit, which has the cable TV line coming into this building. You don't have, the conduit doesn't cause any problem, it's going to induce a signal. This clamp is connected through this cord down here to this port called clamp, very obvious. So what I do is I put the frequency in the induction mode, the light will come on in induction. Now I'm transmitting, instead of out of those alligator clip ports, I'm transmitting out this cord to this clamp and inducing a signal onto this cable TV cable. Now there's a couple of things you need to know about inductive clamps. They're not the be-all, end-all. There's always going to be some kind of limitation, pros and cons. You got to have a couple of parameters for these to work. One is, just like you are setting up a current flow through a cable when you do a direct connect method, this is the same thing. Only our grounding, you'll notice we're not connected to any ground stakes, just the clamp. The grounding is done through the cables itself. So on this end, on the cable box, you've got a ground, and on the far end, on the cable box out at the street, there's a ground. You can induce a signal to a cable if it's grounded at both ends, and you're between those two grounds. If you're not, if the wire was just to be open-ended on one end, sticking up in the air, and you don't have a path to ground, you're not gonna get a signal, and you're not gonna be able to track it. So you gotta have grounds on both ends. And again, you have to have that clamp between those two grounds to set up that current flow. It will give you signal from here out to the pedestal on the street for the cable TV service. But once you get to that pedestal, the signal's gonna stop because that's where the ground is. If you wanna continue after that pedestal, you're gonna have to put the clamp on the other side of that pedestal and use those two grounds and continue to leapfrog wherever it is you wanna go. But the key thing to note here is grounded on both ends and you're between those two grounds, and you'll light up that section of cable, but only that section of cable. So right now it's sending a signal. I'm on the induction mode. For the wand, I have to also select induction mode or I won't get any signal, okay? And again, if you mismatch the receiver and the transmitter, you're not gonna get any signals. And I'll show you what it looks like here if the cameraman wants to follow me. If I get over here, now I know the cable goes out in this direction. I'll put it on induction mode. And I've got a null here. And that's where my cable is, okay? It's a really nice method because look, I didn't have to hook up anything as far as alligator clips. I didn't have to disconnect anybody. If I'm trying to do a electrical line that's active AC, I don't want to mess around with electricity, so I'll just use that clamp. I don't have to call an electrician. Inductive clamp, it's a great way to go, and it's included with an 871C. In the last segment, we talked about using the inductive clamp with the Pro 871C. In this segment, we're going to talk about using the inductive antenna. Very similar principle, just a little bit different in how it's applied. First of all, I'm going to turn the unit on, as always. I'm going to select the frequency as induction, but I'm not going to plug the clamp in here. When I plug that clamp in, it becomes a transmitter for the clamp only. When I'm not plugged in with the clamp, it's sending the transmission signal to the antenna built in here into the case, okay? So now, instead of sending a signal just on the cable that I was tracking, let's say you're in a situation where you don't have access to a cable or the conduit, you want to track somebody's AC circuit across their yard, but you can't get into the box, you can't clamp to it, this is the answer. The inductive antenna will randomly send signal through the ground within a radius of about 15 feet and will light up all the cables in the ground that you have in that area. So I'm transmitting now. Once again, the wand, I'm going to turn it on, and I have to set the frequency that I'm using, in this case induction, to the wand. You see it's working, okay? Again, I'll remind you, if you don't set both up at the same frequency, it's not going to work. So we're both on induction, and now what's happening is all the cables that come out of this area are getting a signal radiated to it from this antenna. And you can track it across the yard just like we showed you tracking the with the clamp. Same signal. The only stipulation you might have with something like this is if you're within 15 feet of the box, you're going to pick up a signal from the box. If you're more than 15 feet away and you're getting a tracking signal, then you are actually tracking cable. Like most things, there's pros and cons. Again, here it's a little more of a shotgun approach. You're sending signal to all cables, so all cables are going to light up, and you kind of have to have an idea which one you want to track. If the cable TV box is out there, then probably the cable TV is going to run this way. So some inductive reasoning needs to be used as well. Again, and you have to be more than 15 feet away from the box. So that's the inductive antenna mode. Very useful, especially if you can't get access to cables. The Pro 871C has a very interesting feature which we call passive mode or 50-60 hertz mode. And what it does, or what it's good for, is finding electrical circuits, live ones, that are actually transmitting AC voltage without using a transmitter and without connecting anything to the cable that's transmitting. So on this building here, we have an electrical service, like, you know, buildings all across the country, and it has a cable running through this yard going out to the curb, and it's providing the electrical service. So if I want to track that cable and I don't want to hook up the transmitter, I don't want to disconnect, I'm not an electrician, I don't want to burn my fingers, this is a way to do it. So first, forget the transmitter, got nothing to do with this. I turn the receiver on, and on my modes, I'm going to switch it to the one that says 60 hertz. Now you hear that buzzing? That buzzing is the electrical 60 hertz signal that you normally get off an AC power circuit. And I'm going to track that. I'm going to use that for a tracking signal. So right now, I'm in the null mode. So as I go over the cable, I get a null right here. And now I track the cable. I can also do it in the peak mode. But again, you know, think about the possibilities here. I don't have to use a transmitter. I don't have to disconnect anything. I follow the electrical circuit across the yard, and away I go.